Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Investor Intel. I'm Peter Clausi. A new story to be told today based on a massive discovery last year. We have Kodiak Copper and its CEO, Claudia Tornquist. Claudia, thank you for being here.
Thanks for having me. It's a pleasure.
I will admit that I had not heard the Kodiak Copper story until I started doing my research. So would you mind giving us some background on the history of how we got here?
Very happy to. So Kodiak was founded in 2015, actually, and initially was a diamonds company. But the diamond market has been very difficult over the last couple of years. So about 2 years ago, we made a strategic sort of shift and acquired two copper projects, the MPD project in southern BC and the Mohave project in Arizona, both copper porphyries. And since then, the company is really focused on copper. And last year, we drilled MPD, our most advanced project, and we're very fortunate to make a really nice discovery very early on in our exploration work.
So those results are out in the public domain. You raised money, changed the name, and now you're back in the field doing work in southern BC.
That's correct. We drilled 6,700 meters last year, relatively small drill program, and then took a little break over the holidays and are now just getting ready to drill again. We're moving into bigger premises and getting everything ready to be back on the ground with the drill turning in February.
Do you find that it's longer lead times now for assay results?
We had, I think, 30 days when we put the first assays through, and just a week ago or two, we had noticed from the lab that it's 89 days now. So we're still waiting for the final results from the 2020 drill campaign, which we're also expecting in February.
What I found interesting about the MPD results was the gold. It seems elevated for that part of the world.
Well, we've certainly had some interesting gold values in our discovery holes, and we had a section where we had essentially 1-to-1 of percentage copper to grades per ton gold. That bodes well, and that's obviously encouraging. Gold is always, or can be, a big contributor to the economics in a porphyry mine.
As does the silver, which shows up from time to time in your holes.
Yeah.
It's a good time to be in silver.
It's certainly interesting days these days in silver.
And what's nice is it appears that much of the mineralization begins at or close to surface.
That's correct. Our initial discovery hole was an 800-meter hole that was essentially mineralized top to bottom from bedrock surface to all the way down to over 800 meters. Our two high-grade discovery holes, from which we have the results already, they were had the best grades sort of between 300-400 meters downhole. And yeah, so at the moment, that's sort of what we are seeing. And really, we still have a lot of work to do to see, firstly, where the best grades are, and then also where they come closest to the surface. But there's certainly a lot of material, gold and copper, drilled over a large footprint historically already at shallow depth.
Now, what about the property down in Arizona? Was it Arizona or Nevada?
Arizona.
Which part of Arizona?
Pardon me?
Which part of Arizona?
Vicinity of a large copper porphyry mine owned by Freeport called Bagdad, just 30-something kilometers to the west of that. And it's in Arizona's copper belt. It's obviously a very good address for copper. And very similar to MPD, it's got great infrastructure, literally right off the highway, has some historic results already, a lot of smoke and interesting sniffs, but nobody really has figured it out yet. And we also plan to work on Mohave in 2021.
On a corporate front, you are blessed to have one of the international mining companies as a major shareholder.
Yes, we do. We had Teck Resources invest $8 million in our private placement last year in September after we made the high-grade discovery. That's obviously great, a great vote of confidence into our project and company, and they are a great partner to have on board. They know the area really well. They have a big porphyry mine just north of us, Highland Valley, and so technically they are second to none, and to have them as a partner is great.
Well, they must have done a fair amount of due diligence before writing an $8 million check.
They certainly did. It's actually quite an interesting story. They were on a site visit last year in summer. They signed a CA, and so we showed them what we had drilled. And that was just as we were drilling the initial high-grade discovery hole. So they didn't see any of what we had drilled there yet because we were just in the midst of it. And they'd left, and then we showed them a picture of what we had just drilled, just a picture of the core, and they literally turned around right away, came back to site a couple of days later to look at what we had drilled in. It was hole four at the time. That was the hole we came out with first that created all the excitement in the market, and they liked what they saw and consequently invested.
And from a corporate standpoint, you're blessed to have only 40 million shares out.
Yeah, 44.8 million is our share count at the moment. That's something many of our shareholders very much like, the tight share structure.
Well, I like it as well. And just checking things out today, because I have this up on my screen, let's call it $1.60 times 44 is roughly a $60 to $65 million market cap.
Yep.
Lots of room to grow.
Correct. For sure. And I'm very excited about 2021 because obviously we have 30,000 meters of drilling ahead of us and some really good targets. The gate zone, the high grade discovery, we've only really scratched the surface and drilled 100 or a bit more meters of an anomaly that's a kilometer long. And so, yeah, lots more discovery potential there and more other targets. So, yeah, it'll be an exciting year.
Will you be going to site?
Yes, well, the project is a three-hour drive from Vancouver, where we are headquartered, so it's very easy to get there. It's obviously also a big bonus. Last year, we had a site visit, and I literally packed some analysts from the airport in Vancouver into the car, into the truck, and drove up to the project, and yeah, we were there 3 hours later. There aren't many mining projects, I think, where you can do that.
So, the symbol is KDK, trades on the Venture Exchange. I strongly encourage anyone who wants to know more about the company to read the January 5th press release, which was the annual report to the shareholders, and it lays out the story in a very well-written way. So congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Claudia, it was very nice to meet you. Thank you for bringing me up to speed on the story.
Thank you, Peter. It's been a pleasure.
Peter Clausi signing off from Investor Intel. Have a safe day.